What I specifically do robotically are often ventral hernia repairs. And a ventral hernia is just any hernia on your front. So belly button, above the belly button, in an incision on the abdominal wall somewhere. And then the other is any operation that requires us to operate low in the pelvis. So specifically if we need to operate on the rectum or the lower part of the intestinal tract.
I got diagnosed with endometriosis when I was 29. And shortly thereafter, we did an exploratory surgery and removed all that. And a couple of months later, a few days before my 30th birthday, we did a partial hysterectomy, had endometriosis again really bad. So we made an appointment to have the other tube and ovary removed. The next day I had the colonoscopy and they found a tumor the size of a tennis ball in my rectum.
The main thing with robotic surgery is that it allows us to give access to minimally invasive surgery to many patients who wouldn't necessarily have been candidates before, because we are able to do more operations, do them better, have less risk of needing to change those operations to an old-fashioned open approach. And so again, it allows us to provide better care for our patients and again, help them through their entire surgical process.
The day before, you know, she sat me down and told me everything that was gonna happen, start to finish, completely. I've never had anyone be so thorough in my life. Tell me exactly what was gonna happen from the moment I walked in to when I went home. She said the heal time would be better, it'd be easier. There were less complications, less things that could go wrong. I was also nervous because she explained to me that it was a long surgery. That's the longest one I've ever had. But if I had a choice of something serious again, I think I'd choose that.
One of the misconceptions with robotic surgery is that it's actually a robot that we're using. And in reality, it's not a robot. By definition, a robot is autonomous. And what the robotic surgery is actually computer-enhanced surgery. So instead of standing at the patient's side using my instruments, I'm sitting at what's essentially a computer console with hand pieces and running my instruments through the computer. And again, the advantage of that is we can make much smaller movements than we would necessarily make. For some surgeons, if there's any shaking, that it can be eliminated with the computer. And again, the instruments can get into smaller spaces because they're designed to be much smaller than our regular laparoscopic instruments.
Robotic surgery definitely made a difference. It was much quicker and it wasn't as painful as I thought it was going to be. Like what was actually repaired, I didn't have any pain where the repair was, just where all the instruments went into my belly button.
As a center of excellence in robotic surgery, what that means is that the administration and the staff at Johnston-Willis have a significant dedicated interest in being able to provide these sorts of operations for their patients, which means that if I have a patient that I believe is an appropriate candidate and would be a good candidate for robotic surgery, I have everything I need to ensure that they have the access to that operation.
After her explanation, and as thorough as she is, and of course I go on to Google and I look at these things and go to forums and testimonies, and I read everything, and it seemed like the right thing to do, and I trust her. If you ask anybody in Richmond, you tell them her name and they say she is the best.